Well, I am not involved in a gang, so I can't tell you if it's a breakaway faction from a gang. First, I want to condemn the killings. I want to condemn the criminal activities that have taken place. But I also want to indicate that the constituency of Central St. Catherine has experienced relative peace over the last decade. I've had really great social intervention programs, and I have had to deal with the good, the bad, and the ugly, and I know I've changed a lot of people's lives, and I have made them feel that life is worth living. The infrastructure is not in great condition, but we have been doing what we can in an incremental way to improve the infrastructure and to improve people's lives. I graduated over 40 persons in constabulary, another 40 in bartending, and even the men who do construction work, I've been able to get them certification. And we have lawyers and doctors coming out of these communities. I have over 60 students right now who are at the tertiary level. So I just want to put in perspective that the communities that we're talking about, there are more good people than bad people. Now, the current situation is one where there has been issues in an adjoining constituency, and it has spilled over into this constituency because persons moved out of the adjoining constituency, and it is said that they have moved into this constituency. And that is why, in the first place, a section of the constituency was attacked. And once that happens, then the situation gets tense, and working closely with the police, I have tried my best to ensure that there's no reprisal, that the situation does not continue. But what we're experiencing is people driving into the constituency and shooting at innocent individuals and other persons, and this is now creating great attention.
It is said that it is a breakaway faction in the one other gang that is causing this conflict. Can you comment on that?
Well, I am not involved in a gang, so I can't tell you if it's a breakaway faction from a gang. Once there are incidents that are connected to the communities that are in strong support of the Jamaica Labour Party, then the elements that are involved are labeled one order. But what I can tell you, I haven't heard the name one order called in the communities around for a long time. They have been focused on how they can improve their lives. The incident, as I said, is as a result of an adjoining constituency where there are some youngsters who I think are a little out of control, because, you know, it seemed that criminal activities at this time, it involves a lot of young people. And as a result, they have less regard, less respect for elders, less regard for order and structure and so on. So I can't say to you it's a breakaway. What I can say to you is that one element from an adjoining constituency have their internal conflicts. People move out of that community. It is said they have moved into this constituency, and it is creating tension now between those. That is what I pick up on the ground. That's the information I have.
The business community, businessmen, they are saying, Minister, that there is a new trend in the extortion situation in the town, in that the original businessmen, those who were born in Spanish Town, that weren't being targeted in the initial stages, are now being targeted. And the sums that they are asking is exorbitant. Are you aware of this, and what are the plans from the Ministry?
Well, I'm not aware of the details of that. Extortion is a major criminal activity out here. And one of the things we need is some level of cooperation. The government is investing in a number of ways to give support to the police, not only in legislation, but in terms of surveillance and communication mobility, and that is crucial, because we expect the support of the citizens. Of course, extortion is a business which very few people talk about. And that creates a very, almost a difficult hurdle to overcome, because unless someone is willing to establish by evidence that, that John Brown is an extortionist, it's difficult for the police to act. The police also have knowledge. Intelligence gives us a pretty good picture of all that's happening. But in our system, the bar for evidence is extremely high. Not that I'm dismissing it, but it is what it is, and it's something that we have to look at it. You know, we need the cooperation of the institution. Unless they cooperate, we're not going to be able to move. What we can and will maintain and improve on is, and keep as we build out the support for the police, is just public order aspect of the situation in Spanish Town. If there's greater public order, then we expect the citizens to give greater cooperation. And by I mean that we have looked at the work of the impact of Jamaica in certain areas, and that will be built up by the government to give police more eyes on the ground. Of course, when they apprehend them, I think the justice system have to take note that those who break public order, especially for some of that extortion or just, I don't know, are the same individuals who are behind the organized criminal activity that kills people. And therefore, they have to address them much more stronger than they are doing. You know, I know the justice system lays out almost a level of incremental punishment, but what we are experiencing in space like Spanish Town is organized criminal activity, and it goes from minor stealing, right, just pickpocket on the road. He operates freely because the gang protects him, on the way up to extortion of big money from the bigger wholesaler. It's a network, and whenever any of them are apprehended with enough evidence, the justice system have to make an example of them. And I think that's a message that I think the community itself need to send across. Okay, if they collaborate, if the community cooperates, and we take a man in, and the evidence is given, and he's out by next month, then clear that man, we have to close the business. You know, the entire system have to work together. We are ensuring we can build out the surveillance of Jamaica and other activities the police need to monitor an urban center effectively. But once we get beyond that, when they have the evidence, we also have to get a system that is sensitive to how gangsters operate. Think like what happened nearby here at the railway lane. That's terrorist activity, right? The individuals who carry out that kind of activity are terrorists in other way, because they just come and shoot at people in the community. That is designed to frighten the citizens and build fear.